Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, we can hopefully expect to see another satellite launch on the Falcon 9 in just a matter of days. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the TurkSat 5B satellite is expected to lift off on Sunday 19th at 3:58am UTC or Saturday 18th at 10:58pm Eastern Time. Musk posted a tweet saying SpaceX is starting a program to take CO2 out of atmosphere and turn it into rocket fuel. Please join if interested. He then posted a response of "will also be important for Mars." Over in Boca Chica, crews continue to work on the orbital launch mount. Some lights were also recently added to the mount. The orbital tank farm was seen doing some venting recently. Further concrete work has been going on around the launch site. The second level of the wide bay has begun assembly with this prefabricated section installed. Jeff Faust posted some information related to SpaceX from a VP called Tom Ochinero. The first says planning at least 3 human spaceflight missions next year, maybe more. First Starship orbital flight attempt still planned for January to February. The next tweet said, "We have been actively marketing Starship to commercial customers and signed up some already." Then he also posted saying, "Talking to insurers about Starship, but initial flights will be with our Starlink satellites. By the time external customers ready to fly, we've reduced the risk and thus premiums." Ship 20 has continued to be worked on for its next static fire test. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the closure for yesterday was cancelled. There was also a closure scheduled for today, but that has been cancelled too. Then there's also closures scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 16th and Friday 17th. Eric Ralph posted a couple of tweets related to Ship 20. The first says, "Very odd. SpaceX is removing Starship S20's nose hardpoints without which the ship can't be lifted on or off the test stand. I think at least half of them have been removed. Really can't think of an obvious reason for doing so." Then he also posted saying, "One explanation I can think of is that SpaceX wants a slightly more complete heat shield during upcoming cryo or static fire testing. Or maybe it's replacing them with an upgraded design. Or S20 is going to be intentionally tested to failure. Work continues on the Ship 21 nose cone with it getting closer to being ready. The body section is also continuing to be worked on in the mid bay. This common dome section in the middle here is for Starship 24. The B2.1 test tank was worked on recently and Chris Burgin posted this tweet. He said test tank B2.1 has a brand new hat. It is expected there will be a crush test on this test tank in the near future. The Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype was moved back to and lifted on the orbital launch mount. Here's a view of the Booster 6 test tank being worked on in the high bay. To finish today's video, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to thank Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for being out there all the time filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to Nick Ansawini for being out there filming some of the Starbase content too. As well as that, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.